Welcome back to NewsPlus, everyone. I'm Mark Seagraves, and now we turn our attention to Alzheimer's. June is Alzheimer and Brain Awareness Month. We are joined by satellite by Ruth Drew with the Alzheimer's Association. Ruth, thanks for joining us this morning.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me, Mark.
So, I everybody has been touched in some way probably at this point by Alzheimer's, either a family member or somebody they know. But there's still a lot we either think we know about Alzheimer's or things that we just don't know about Alzheimer's. Can you first start by telling us just how big a problem and how the problem is growing in the United States?
Absolutely, Mark. Everyone with a brain is at risk for Alzheimer's, and Alzheimer's is the most expensive disease in the nation. So that's why it's important for all of us to get involved in the fight against this disease. And that's why the Alzheimer's Association wants everyone to know the truth about the disease.
And so tell us some of the facts and fictions. What are some of the things that we might have misconceptions about and some of the things that, as you say, the truths about Alzheimer's?
Sure. Alzheimer's disease is not normal aging. It is a fatal progressive disease that currently has no effective treatments that slow down or prevent the disease or cure the disease. And it robs people of their memory, their ability to problem solve and to process information and eventually to function.
What do we do as a caregiver? Because, a lot of this falls on the children. We end up, our generation end up being the caretakers of our parents' generation. How do we cope with this? Because there's a toll that it takes on the family as well as it takes on the patient.
Absolutely. In fact, last year, caregivers and family members delivered over 18 billion hours in unpaid care. So, and we know that taxpayers are paying $18 million an hour for Alzheimer's care and costs. So, yeah, the burden is tremendous for families as well as for the nation as a whole. And, I think it's important to be informed. It's important to know what you're dealing with. And that's why the Alzheimer's Association recommends knowing the signs of Alzheimer's disease and early detection, early diagnosis.
And so give us a couple of those bullet points on what are some of the early warning signs that we might look out for.
Sure. So in addition to memory loss that affects everyday life, people may have difficulty with problem solving and processing information. They may have problems with familiar tasks, things that used to be easy to do, like, balancing your checkbook might not be easy for all of us, but if balancing your checkbook was easy for a person and then all of a sudden it starts taking several hours for them to do that, or any other familiar tasks that become difficult, misplacing things, and we can all misplace things, but then not being able to retrace your steps and not being able to remember that, oh, that's right, I put my keys down when I answered the phone, the phone was ringing when I came in the house, or that sort of thing. So you can get a complete list of the warning signs of Alzheimer's on our website at alz.org.
And Ruth, Ruth Drew is with the Alzheimer's Association. June is Alzheimer's and Brain Awareness Month. And that means we're going to see a lot of people wearing purple this month in solidarity with Alzheimer's Month. Are there support groups for family members that around the country that they can go and at least be with people who are going through the same things?
Absolutely. There are thousands of support groups around the country. There are education programs locally and also on our website. You can connect with other people who are dealing with Alzheimer's through alz.org. We have a group called Alz Connected. It's an online community. And if you want to talk to somebody about Alzheimer's disease, about the warning signs, or about caregiving, dealing with whatever's going on, you can call our 24-hour helpline at 800-272-3900.
Ruth Drew is with the Alzheimer's Association, and June is Alzheimer's and Brain Awareness Month. Ruth, let me ask you, Is there a role that technology can play? Is there, are there apps, devices, anything that we can do that can help bridge the gap between the caregiver and the patient once we're in that space where we have a loved one who's suffering with Alzheimer's?
You know, there are a lot of different apps and different technologies that people are trying. And I think what works for one person may be different from what works for someone else. But people should certainly try things and see what works. Sometimes that can be very high tech or very low tech. I think the important thing is to focus on the individual and figure out what works best for them.
And where are we with research and you know, finding either treatment and or cure for Alzheimer's?
Well, I'm glad you brought that up because research for Alzheimer's is very exciting right now, but we're not there yet. Currently, we have treatments that help with symptoms, but we do not have a cure. We do not have treatments that slow down the disease or prevent the disease. And so that's why this fight is so important, and that's why it's important for all of us to get involved.
Ruth Drew with the Alzheimer's Association, we appreciate you taking time with us this morning. Thanks very much.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.